easy. Soup's easy. Anything that's easy and quick. Sometimes you'd want to shake him and say, come on, Louise, you know, get something down here. But you can't force her. She's got one to impress her.
Louise links her bad dietary habits to early childhood experiences of mealtimes.
On the evening, I'd have cornflakes and avoid having what my mum cooked me. You know, she'd sometimes say, you're not moving until you've eaten that. So I'd stick my hand in and feel a bit. You know, and then she'd say, well, your hands are not.
Let's start straight away with the appointments, okay? So take a little rest in your chair. If you stand up there, you weigh 97 pounds.
At a tiny 6'13", the user slipped under what is considered to be a pudding room.
Change my attitude towards food, have more knowledge about food, and maybe I'd find a rhythm and accept that you have to eat it.
As Louise fast approaches 30, she's desperate to change. The years of bad eating have left her exhausted, and now they're destroying her self-esteem.
When I look in the mirror, I feel disgusting, really. It's just what bones a young person's body. I don't see. Looking to be a mother in the future, and I don't feel mothery at all. I feel like a kid, so I'm more worried now than I've ever been about my life. I just think now's the time to change, because if I don't do it now, I never will.
But help is at hand for Louise in the form of Supersize Eddie from Milton Keynes.
£378.
Eddie tips the scales at a whopping 27.5 stone, and he is a ticking time bomb. With a history of high blood pressure in his family, he needs to radically change his diet before it's too late. Biker Eddie's bad diet begins at 6:30 a.m. with a burly breakfast.
A typical day's food for me would usually start with the leftovers from the night before, whether that be rice, noodles, meats. If I have leftovers and it's not quite enough, I'd throw in another packet of noodles just to bulk it up.
If you're having a Chinese takeaway the night before and you think, oh, I'm full, it all gets scraped in a bowl, and you go, ah, lovely, that's breakfast.
Working as an IT programmer gives Eddie an ample excuse to indulge his enormous appetite.
Mid-morning snack, it would be a packet of crisps, some biscuits maybe, and then for lunch, it will be again rice, noodles, meat dish, and then in the afternoon, a packet of crisps, and then when I get home, a tray of chicken breasts, noodles, and then a glass of wine, or maybe a beer.
39-year-old Eddie's been eating this way ever since he can remember.
My mother and father both enjoyed cooking. Grew up in a big family, so therefore food was a big part of the day. We weren't very well off, so we had to have bulk foods. And then as I grew up, as money became better, and we started having things like rice, chicken, and that was a luxury food. So therefore, I think because it was such a luxury food, that's why I eat so much of it now.
Right, Evan, I've done my sums, and you'll be a moment. 40 million of these, because there's a significant risk of disease and actually death